5 points, nearly half the team's total. Now, Jeff, with 9.5 remaining, a miracle finish would have to obviously happen for Phoenix to pull it out. And again, they're out of timeouts.
That's why you've got to concentrate on the details.
Booker, turn, shoots, fires. Shot won't go, chuck of the rebound. And that'll do it. It's over. The Bucks have done it. The long wait has ended after a half century. The Milwaukee Bucks are NBA champions once again.
Amen, say man. Y'all Bucks fans predicted all of this to happen. The Milwaukee Bucks has defeated the Phoenix Suns in 6 games to capture their first title since 1971 and the second title in their franchise history. And that is in part by the legendary performance that Giannis has put up in this game, putting up 50 points, 14 rebounds, and 5 blocks, clinching the title. He became the first player to record these type of numbers in finals history and also winning a finals MVP. Now, all of that said, the Bucks have done it. They won the title, most especially Giannis winning his first ever championship and finals MVP of his career. To even look at his already illustrious career, he is a back-to-back MVP, most improved player, a defensive player of the year, had the highest single season PER in this league's history, and he accomplished all of this by age 26? Man, what to even say about the future of his career? This is what we finna discuss in this video. I mean, there's a lot that we're going to discuss in this video. First off, how does Giannis winning his first title alter his legacy and what it does to his career when being compared to the all-time greats? And before this video starts, make sure y'all go subscribe to my channel. I make NBA and NFL content. Turn on post notifications, all these things that help support my growth on this channel. And without further ado, stay tuned, cue the intro.
I got this shit from the trap, few baggies, my pen and my pad. I done got rich off a rap, you throwin', we sending them back. That shit is a fact, my young boy ain't got no ID on him, he had to slip through the back.
So Giannis, in this year's finals, has put up one of the most memorable and greatest finals performances of all time. That is a fact. This dude has given everything he got in this series to win a chip. From enduring an ankle injury, coming back not being 100% in game 1, to put up an absolute masterpiece in the last 5 games of this series. And I know that both of the Bucks and the Suns has made it to the finals easily because all of the teams, and some of them who are considered better teams, had their best players out because of injury. But despite all of that, a lot of people, including me, have been questioning the move of Giannis resigning with the Bucks last offseason. Similar to Kobe around 2004 to 2007, where Kobe demanded a trade to the Bulls but decided to stay with the Lakers by the front office promising Kobe to bring pieces for him in order to compete for championships once again. And I know there are differences. Kobe resigned with the Lakers in 2004, and him thinking of getting out of LA was later after he resigned, while Giannis, on the other hand, was thinking of which teams he will sign with before resigning with a Supermax deal. The beauty of both of their decisions to stay with their team that drafted them is that they will both eventually win a championship with the same team. And for Giannis, winning his first chip speaks volumes of what it does to his current legacy. Well, first of all, he's already an all-time great. He has accomplished more than what Jordan, Braun, and even Kawhi Leonard did at 26. Accomplishing more than Michael Jordan when he was 26 is crazy. This chip that he won took a monumental step in Giannis' career, of which going into the direction of being regarded as a top 10, top 5, top 3, maybe the greatest basketball player to ever play the game. And he has shown that he can definitely become regarded in that echelon of players in the history of the NBA. And to really think about it, guys, every one of us knew that Giannis was going to break the NBA, like explode himself into the caliber of one of the all-time greats. And it's really getting started for Giannis right now. Like it started with LeBron when he was with the Heat. To even look at the magnitude of how he won the title is that Giannis has trusted the front office to build a championship team with the moves to assemble the team that we saw win the whole thing right beneath our eyes, and Giannis beat the Phoenix Suns fair and square. He doesn't need to go pull a Kevin Durant or a DeMarcus Cousins, whatever y'all say in the media, and go sign with the Celtics or the Heat and form a super team. Nah, Giannis stayed with his team like he said in the press conference.
You know, obviously I wanted to get the job done. You know, but that's my stubborn side. Like, it's easy to go somewhere and go and win a championship with somebody else. It's easy. I could go, I don't put anybody in the spot, but I could go to a super team and, you know, just do my part and win a championship, still one. But this is the hard way to do it, and this is the way I chose to do it.
He came back from a 2-0 deficit and won with putting up one of the greatest finals performances of all time. Yeah, that is almost up there with Dirk, and most definitely, I will say that Giannis' finals performance and how he won is better and more monumental than what D-Wade did in 06. He deserves so much respect for what he has done in the finals. Throughout that time before Giannis won the title, many of us doesn't see him as the best player in the NBA or even a top 5 player at all, all because of his limitations on his game is preventing him to carry his team to the finals, and often was getting so much ridicule because of his lack of a jumper, and I often worry how the rest of his career will play out if he doesn't win a championship in his career, because he is too good and accomplished so much so young not to win a championship. What Giannis accomplished before winning his first title, going back to back in MVPs, winning a Defensive Player of the Year award, leading his team to consecutive top 3 seeds in the East in the last 2 seasons, having the highest PER in NBA history, I can go on and on. It's obvious that he's an all-time great. He is too good to not win a championship, but now he finally did, along with the performance he had. For those of you in the comment section below by the end of the video that said that Giannis is now the best player in the world right now, I would not be mad at you. The number that he put up in the last 2 seasons, plus the numbers that he put up in the playoffs and the finals, proves that he's in the caliber right now that you can casually make an argument that Giannis is the best player in the NBA. Like I said earlier in the video, it's only getting started for Giannis. Now, how he will win more championships is another discussion for another day. Giannis Antetokounmpo, aka Acompo, has accomplished more accolades than the majority of the all-time greats at the same age as he is. Which is right now, I can officially say that Giannis right now, in a career standpoint, is a top 30 to 20 player in NBA history. And in my opinion, I say that Giannis' career is almost as good as Kawhi Leonard's currently. Now, I know all y'all people will have different opinions of where do y'all put Giannis in the all-time rankings, or where do y'all rank him in the NBA currently. I would like to know what y'all opinions on that subject matter when y'all finish with the video. But the fact of the matter is that Giannis is an all-time great. You can't deny that. He's an obvious first ballot Hall of Famer. He's a one-of-a-kind player. We have never seen a 7-footer this athletic and dominant since Shaq, and Giannis already accomplished more than Shaq at age 26. It's just simple. He's just special. I wonder where Giannis will sit all time when it's all said and done. If everything sits towards Giannis's favor, like for example winning 1 or 2 MVPs and winning 2 more championships, then I can potentially see him as a top 5, top 3, maybe in the GOAT conversation sometime later into his career around his early 30s. Whether Bron will win 1 or 2 more championships and be officially regarded as the GOAT, we can see Giannis and LeBron GOAT conversation sometime in the future, or Giannis MJ GOAT conversation. I'm not God, and certainly you're not. We can't accurately predict the future. But anyways guys, let's focus on the current moment, and that is seeing the start of a legendary career with Giannis Acompo by seeing him win his first ever championship. Thank y'all for watching the vid. Make sure y'all subscribe for more NBA and NFL videos. I usually post 1 or 2 videos per week, so don't miss out on the Liddy videos I'm gonna bring to y'all. And that's all. Stay Liddy. This is the A-Man Show. Sign out.